Donald Trump has, of course, been attacking Nikki Haley a lot more than usual recently, and part of the reason for that is because Nikki Haley is now his only remaining Republican opponent. She is, you know, a solid second place because there's only two people, and Trump wants her out of the race for good so he can focus on being himself, I guess. But it makes no sense for him to just keep attacking her when she's not winning. Okay, she has no realistic path to getting that nomination unless Donald Trump like gets in some kind of jet ski accident this weekend and can't run for office. Other than that, Nikki Haley's not going to win. So why is he wasting his time? Why is he wasting his breath attacking her every time he does a rally or every time he gets on Truth Social or every time he does an interview? It doesn't make any sense. It's not necessary. But to Trump it is. Because there is something happening behind the scenes that Donald Trump is super pissed about. And he's hinted at it in the last couple days, but now we know what's really happening. According to the recent financial disclosure statements from both Nikki Haley's super PAC and Donald Trump's super PAC, it turns out that Nikki Haley has actually outraised Donald Trump. She raised $5 million more dollars in the last 6 months than Donald Trump's super PAC did. And she is helped on by Wall Street. They've given her a ton of money. Corporations love Nikki Haley. They see her as the safe alternative to Donald Trump. Same policies, but just kind of a better packaging, right? It's not as abrasive and disgusting as Donald Trump is. So Wall Street corporations have come in and they've helped Nikki Haley by giving her a ton of money. And Trump is furious about that. Now, a couple days ago, Donald Trump went out there and he said that any donor giving money to Nikki Haley, from this point forward, he said, we're going to excommunicate you. You are not welcome in the MAGA movement, because he's trying to bully these companies and these wealthy individuals into no longer giving money to Nikki Haley because he knew these numbers already. He knew that he was getting crushed in the fundraising. Additionally, he knows that the Republican Party apparatus as an entity itself, the national party and the state level parties, they don't have any money. They can't raise anything. So Trump's having fundraising problems. The Republican Party's having fundraising problems. Nikki Haley's not. She's got all that money. And Donald Trump wants it so bad he can taste it. So he's trying to bully them into not giving to Nikki Haley. He's trying to insult her and attack her every chance he gets so people stop giving her money. And for the record, Trump's not going to excommunicate any donors at all. He is not going to ban them from being a part of the MAGA movement. He loves money. He'll do whatever it takes to get money. And he's not ever going to say, no, I don't want your money. I don't think he's capable of physically saying that to somebody. So he wants the money. Nikki Haley's getting it. And as long as she stays in the race, she's going to continue getting money. And it's going to suck available funds away from the Republican Party. It's going to suck available funds away from Donald Trump. And ultimately, it's going to be used to get Nikki Haley a solid second place finish. But if Trump wants his hands on that money, he only has one option at this point. He has to choose Nikki Haley as his running mate. So as long as Haley stays in the race and she continues to build up that war chest, she has something of value, of monetary value, that Trump wants. He won't get it if he doesn't pick her, but if he picks her, she can use that money to elevate the overall campaign. So it's setting up an interesting dynamic. It explains several things for us. It explains why Trump is going so hard against Nikki Haley. It explains why Nikki Haley is staying in the race. Nikki Haley says she doesn't want to be the vice president. Trump's allies say they do not want her to be the vice president. But financially speaking, the two parties may be left with no other options than to rely on each other, because Nikki Haley is sucking up all the cash and Trump absolutely hates that. Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.